On Christmas Day, while people in Italy drink hot chocolate under their blankets, Brazilians are at the beach drinking some ice beverages. All of this could, however, change in the future. Imagine a world where the snow never stops falling, the cold never fades, and survival becomes a daily struggle. If a long winter period strikes the Earth, we would find ourselves in a post-apocalyptic state. Resource scarcity would be the first issue to hit us. The ground would freeze solid, crops would perish, and food would become scarce. To survive, we would need to choose between hoarding and sharing. Those who choose to hoard would become isolated and eventually come to ruin. Scientists think we might find ourselves in this situation in the years to come. There are cycles on Earth that are in conflict. Periods of hot weather alternate with cold ones. However, these conflicts won't last forever. In the future, the conflict will eventually stop and a long winter will come. But how do these cycles work? Join me to get to know more about it. Surrounded by cycles. Let's start by saying that here on Earth, we're basically surrounded by cycles. Let me explain. Our lives literally revolve around them. A series of events that are repeated regularly in the same order. There are hundreds of different types of cycles in our world and in the universe. Some are natural, such as the change of the seasons, annual animal migrations, or the circadian rhythms that govern our sleep patterns. Others are human-produced, like growing and harvesting crops, musical rhythms, or economic cycles. Every year on the 25th of December, the world celebrates Christmas Day. In the collective imagination, Christmas is made of snow and hot chocolate. This day is associated with snow and Santa riding his reindeer, bringing gifts and joy to all people, whether they're kids or adults. However, if you live in Brazil, you'll probably notice one thing. Christmas Day falls during summer. Many people like to go to the beach to tan. For the Brazilian people, there's no hot chocolate on Christmas. It would be crazy to even think about making one. You might want to eat an ice cream instead. The one and only reason why this happens is because of seasons. The cycle of seasons. You might already know why we have seasons, but I think it's worth reviewing, as this will serve as a starting point to understand the main topic of this video, the Milankovitch cycles. The reason why we have seasons is due to the revolution of Earth around the Sun and the inclined axis. As our planet orbits the Sun, the tilt of its axis causes different parts of the world to receive varying amounts of sunlight. This results in the changing of seasons in different parts of the world at different times of the year. During the summer, the hemisphere that is tilted towards the sun receives more direct sunlight, resulting in longer days and warmer temperatures. Conversely, the hemisphere that is tilted away from the sun experiences shorter days and cooler temperatures. This contrasting pattern is reversed during winter, when the hemisphere tilted away from the sun receives less direct sunlight, resulting in shorter days and cooler temperatures. Spring and fall are the transition seasons between summer and winter, and they occur when the Earth's axis is neither tilted towards nor away from the sun. During these seasons, the amount of sunlight received is more evenly distributed across the Earth, resulting in moderate temperatures and more balanced weather patterns. Seasons have a significant impact on life on Earth. Plants and animals have adapted to the changing climate, using cues such as temperature and day length to regulate their life cycles. Many animals migrate to warmer climates during the winter months, and some plants only flower during certain seasons. In addition to its impact on the natural world, seasons also affect human activities. Seasonal changes can influence everything from our moods and behavior to the economy. For example, winter sports and activities are popular in places where it snows, while beach activities are more prevalent in places with warmer climates. As you can see, seasons are an important cycle that repeats regularly, with each season bringing new growth and changes to the natural world. All over the course of one year, periods of warm weather alternate to colder ones. The Milankovitch cycles. So the presence of seasons is due to the particular configuration of a planet's axial tilt with respect to its orbiting plane around the host star. But as the Serbian scientist Milutin Milankovitch pointed out a century ago, this is not the only factor capable of having an impact on Earth's weather and climate. This genius hypothesized that the long-term collective effects of changes in Earth's position relative to the Sun are a strong driver of Earth's long-term climate and are responsible for triggering the beginning and end of glaciation periods, ice ages. Did I already mention this guy was a genius? He knew very well that the orbit of a planet is described by what aerospace engineers call the orbital elements. These are six important quantities that help describe the movement of an object around another object, whether it is an artificial satellite like the JWST around the Earth or a star around the black hole at the center of our galaxy. He first asked himself what would happen to the Earth if one of these elements, the so-called eccentricity, slowly changed over time. Changes in eccentricity. The eccentricity gives information about the shape of an orbit. When it is zero, the orbit is a circle. The more you depart from zero, the more stretched and elliptic your orbit is. The thing is, due to the gravitational perturbations of Saturn and Jupiter and other minor factors, the Earth's eccentricity, which is quite low, can vary over time, changing the shape of Earth's orbit around the Sun. This in turn affects the distance between the two bodies. Eccentricity is the reason why our seasons are slightly different lengths, with summers in the northern hemisphere currently about 4.5 days longer than winters, and springs about 3 days longer than autumns. As eccentricity decreases, the length of our seasons gradually evens out. What Milankovitch did was to examine how these variations affect how much solar radiation reaches the top of Earth's atmosphere, as well as where this radiation reaches. He found out that when the Earth's orbit is at its most elliptic, about 23% more incoming solar radiation reaches Earth at our planet's closest approach to the Sun each year than it does at its farthest departure from the Sun. Currently, Earth's eccentricity is near its least elliptic, most circular, and is very slowly decreasing in a cycle that spans about 100,000 years. However, the change in global annual insolation due to the eccentricity cycle is very small. Because variation in Earth's eccentricity are fairly small, they are a relatively minor factor in annual seasonal climate variations. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Changes in obliquity. But that's not the end of it. This genius, Milankovitch, also took into account something else, the obliquity and axial precession. The obliquity is the angle between the plane of the Earth's orbit and that of the Earth's equator. This tilt has varied between 22.1 and 24.5 degrees over the last million years. The greater the tilt, the more extreme our seasons are. Think scorching hot summers and bone-chilling winters. Interestingly enough, a larger tilt angle actually leads to periods of deglaciation. So basically, more tilt equals more melting and retreat of glaciers and ice sheets. But this effect isn't uniform worldwide. Higher latitudes experience a greater change in total solar radiation than areas near the equator. Currently, Earth's axis is tilted about halfway between its extremes at 23.4 degrees. And get this, that tilt angle is slowly decreasing in a cycle that lasts about 41,000 years. With his calculations, Milankovitch found out that while our winters will gradually become warmer and our summers cooler, snow and ice will begin to build up in high latitudes. This leads to large ice sheets reflecting more of the Sun's energy back into space, which, you guessed it, promotes even further cooling. Axial precession. For what concerns axial precession, let me first explain what it is. I don't know if you're aware of this, but the Earth wobbles slightly on its axis like a spinning toy top. This wobble, caused by tidal forces from the Sun and Moon, affects Earth's rotation and is known as axial precession. This cycle lasts about 27.7 thousand years and makes seasonal differences more extreme in one hemisphere and less extreme in the other. Currently, perihelion, Earth's closest point to the Sun, occurs during winter in the northern hemisphere and summer in the southern hemisphere. But in about 13,000 years, this will switch, causing the northern hemisphere to experience more extreme solar radiation and the southern hemisphere to have more moderate seasons. There's also apsidal precession, where Earth's entire orbital ellipse wobbles due to interactions with Jupiter and Saturn. This cycle lasts about 112,000 years and changes Earth's orbit orientation relative to the elliptical plane. Combined axial and apsidal precession have an overall precession cycle lasting about 23,000 years on average. And fun fact, Earth's North Star changes over time, with Polaris and Polaris Australis being the current stars. But a few thousand years ago, it was Kochab and Perkab. Milankovitch's crazy prediction. The small changes set in motion by Milankovitch cycles operate separately and together to influence this Earth's climate over very long time spans, leading to larger changes in our climate over tens of thousands to hundreds of thousands of years. Still, what he found is both very interesting and scary. At some point, we, the Earth, will eventually be experiencing another ice age. The two main assumptions posed by Milankovitch were, 1. That the changes in radiation at some latitudes and in some seasons are more important than others. 2. That the obliquity is the most important of the three cycles for the climate. Putting these into his own mathematical model, he calculated that ice ages occur approximately every 41,000 years. Given that the last ice age we know of happened roughly 20,000 years ago, this would in turn mean that the next ice age will be happening in 20,000 years or so. However, subsequent research confirmed that ice ages did occur at 41,000-year intervals between 1 and 3 million years ago. But about 800,000 years ago, the cycle of the ice ages lengthened to 100,000 years, matching Earth's eccentricity cycle. While various theories have been proposed to explain this transition, scientists do not yet have a clear answer. This problem is also known as the transition problem. In any case, according to the most recent astronomical measurements, there won't be a new ice age before 50 to 100,000 years. Predictions accuracy. Making predictions when it comes to long-term climate on planet Earth is no picnic. In principle, a good estimate of the variations of the orbital elements over time would make everything easy, if we only had a good model linking these variations to climate variations. However, the orbital forcing mechanism that acts on the climate is still not completely understood. Currently, we lack a good model that expresses the climate changes in the function of the orbital ones. Due to these reasons, research to better understand the mechanisms that cause changes in Earth's rotation and how specifically Milankovitch cycles combine to affect climate is still ongoing. But the theory that they drive the timing of glacial-interglacial cycles is well accepted. That's all for this video. Thank you so much for watching. What would you like to hear next? Let us know in the comments below. See you next time on the channel.